Pain'll make you a man, or make you a woman. Pain'll break you down, man. I tell you, I was in a doctor's office yesterday. He's just like, and if I, just before I left, he's like, do you want to do this final examination? And I was like, I don't know. I was like, you already did the and now you're going to stick this big plastic thing, look like a mini dildo, just, and he stuck it in and did like the little scope thing and found out I had the dreaded hemorrhoids. Those little bumps have made my life hell since February of last year. Almost missed out going out to GrowthCon 4. Bought myself a $3,000 first class ticket. I thought I was ready to go, and woke up with the pain. And like I went down, I was on my way to the airport that day. Started to rain, and it was sensitive to cold. It was just miserable. And then finally the doctor said, yeah, just do this and that, and then you're done. So that's what happens when you just keep going. I said, you know what? I need to find a solution. I was feeling better, but I wasn't to that point where I felt like super good. Went to the doctor, have a solution, feeling better. Now, some of you are going to feel the pain in 2020. I was just driving down the street today on Waterman Avenue. There are two warehouses going in, two giant warehouses. I remember when Calvin and I, we maybe worked in like, I don't know, it's like a 14,000 square, 40,000 square foot. I don't know the exact acreage. It's just like maybe half a block long from block to block. So however long that is, say it's at least 40,000 square feet. Now look at these. They call them acre block or 5 acre feet. They break out, they take the acreage and break it into feet. And I'm just thinking to myself, how many warehouses can you possibly work at? I worked at Macy's, and I know what a mall is. You know, you buy stuff. There's just not that much out there. It can't be that much demand out there. I know we're a country that's creating warehouse jobs, but I don't think people are buying that much stuff, because I was in the parking lot yesterday. And like the Barnes & Noble and all that. And the ones that are especially not the name brand ones or the franchise ones, there's hardly anyone there. There's even a Verizon store with like a 4 or 5 people. And I'm thinking, like I told you, Calvin and I worked in a warehouse. However big it was, there's only two of us. We produced 20,000 parts. We did soldering. We ran injection molding machines. We moved stuff around. We packaged stuff. It was two of us. There was a CNC machine. There was the like first computerized milling machine. There was a lathe, and there was some other equipment. And we ran that ourselves, and it was only three of us. And we didn't have on vests. We didn't have on goggles. There was no line on the ground telling us where to go. We didn't pick stuff, whatever. What do you call themselves now? Pickers? And like this one, this video today is just for you guys working in a warehouse. Just look around you. Do you really think this warehouse needs all the people? You think you need all? I look at all the cars parked out there and stuff. I'm like, come on, man. What are they picking? A part per hour? I mean, what I'm trying to tell you is, I'm going to GrowthCon 4 because I realize the only way to be successful in this 2020, you got to know how to sell, how to market. At least do it yourself to the basically before you pay someone to help you do it. At least know the basic. And you got to have to know how to sell. Like, you got to know how to convince people to do stuff. Because basically, if we're a consumer society, we don't produce anything anymore. I drive by looking at all these warehouses, and I just feel for some of these people, man. Because I hope those people working in those warehouses are working on their skills, saving up money. Not just living at home, not just buying expensive cars, because that's going to be like just a threat for the nation, and like people graduating from colleges with MBAs. I'm on my way to warehouse. I'm going to be the lead picker associate. And like, my man, my woman, you know, they're working on technology to have like all that stuff done electronically. I don't know when it's going to happen. I know it's a lot of stuff testing, especially at Amazon. So I think within like 2 or 3 years, I know next month, as soon as January 20 hits and this impeachment stuff takes off, the logistics is going to like come to some type of halt. I mean, something's got to give. I mean, this is the big season. If all these warehouses are going to be full, they're going to be full now. And after that, I don't see it, because you're saying, Martin, why do you say that? Well, I lived on that 2008-2010 recession, and what brought things to a halt was there was no credit. Once the credit dried up, and the Ponzi scheme of paying and hoping to get something to pay later to someone, at least giving them a percentage, came to an end, that's what led to all the collapse. It's just like a house of dominoes, because everyone started calling for their money. Hey, pay me, pay me. And that's why I put a lot of these the trucking companies out of business, because they had dropped off a lot of products at warehouse and distributor centers. And you have your 90-day late bill of lading things, and they never got paid because a lot of those companies just went out of business because the retail customer that they worked for went out of business and went bankrupt. So what I want you to do is I want you to comment below, like, do you work at Macy's, work at Amazon? Are you a Prolistic? Are you a Pep Boy fulfiller? Write down, and like, I want you to like look around all those people around you, walk through your parking lot and think to yourself, do you really need at least half those people there? And remember my story about Calvin and I at Petavina Mode and Die. Now, what I do now, if you're going to work there now, you got to make yourself valuable. So if you're going to make yourself valuable, you got to work on your people skills, man. When I mean work on your people skills, you just got to know how to listen, how to negotiate, how to persuade, how to get people to actually act. I mean, how you get follow up. And also how to start a conversation, because you know how I talk about the paper plate guys and the muscle bound guys. They're just a dying breed, man. Because I think 2020 is going to be the year of the woman, because I believe after that 2008-2010, that's all they really were hiring, a lot of women, because they were just more neutral, and like the muscle and aggressive guys were like, who would you give your money to? A woman? When you're in a bad mood, or you're going to give it to a guy who's going to try to be a jerk on top of it. So, I mean, you're going to see all that come to a head, where you're going to see like a big separation between women and men. Because I already see it. Because you go to the gym and you look at the guys and they're with the girlfriend and they got their earphones on and their little earbuds, trying to be texting, and they're with the woman. And my man, like I tell you, the woman don't want to talk to you. So the more you text, the more earphones you put in, it's the better for her. She's mostly keeping them around. Let me get in shape and stuff. And then I'm going to show the paper plate guy the door. And then he'll go, whatever, do his bizarre stuff. Go join his friends to play Call of Duty or whatever. Or look at themselves in the mirror in the bathroom for the other guys. And they can maybe become gay when it's all said and done. So. And also, I told you before, I see the divorce rate creeping up, because these older women are going to see what these younger women are doing and the type of freedoms they have. And they say, why am I with this jerky guy who's trying to tell me what to do? He's out of shape and he's basically an idiot. If I've already slept around him 3 or 4 times, because what did I tell you? 15% of women are having affairs. 20% of men who are married are having affairs. And they're going to just think to themselves, why? What's the point? You know, women make more than men. Maybe back then I could have stayed with this guy, but now, hey, you know, I want to go try something different. And I don't care how many muscles he has, how aggressive he has. And, you know, I'm going to just kick him to the curb. So watch that. That's what you're going to see next year. So the only way to stay valuable, what did I say? You got to make money. If you're a man, you better work on your people skills, because these women are going to start really clamping down. And work, like, if you're a guy, even if you make money and you're a jerk, hey, in your state like California, 50-50, hey, they'll go with you a while, marry you, get your money, and take 50% of what you got. So, pain has cleared my mind. I had 1 year, like, this year I was coming out of it, still a little bit sore, but I'm starting to come out of it now, and I kind of see the world, because when you're in pain, you deal with people, because you're trying to keep yourself going at a high enough level when you're in pain that you really can just reach out and slap some people that are around you. But now, like, I'm kind of like coming out of my haze, I just realized, man, there's a lot of idiots, man. I just look at people and like I realized men are really in trouble right now. I didn't think it was as bad as I thought, but I see it, the men, they just, a lot of the guys just have no people skills. They're just like, I don't know what happened. And this is what happened through that 2008 recession, because the men or fathers they work with probably got divorced, because if you can't deliver the bread, the wife is making the money, and your guy's still a jerk, got rid of the guy. So you got a lot of kids that are just raised by, a lot of divorces, so kids are being raised by kids. But unfortunately, the kids they're being raised by are as dumb as them. So as I head out now, I just want you to think, money's important. Work on your people skills. What is your plan to avoid pain in 2020? Because the pain is coming. I've went through 3 recessions, been laid off, 2001, 2008, 2010, lost foreclosures, went into debt by tens of thousands of dollars. And I know what happens when things get tight, people don't pay. Are you wide enough to be able to lose 1 or 2 customers for your business? Or is your business going to have to go out of business? Or are you going to have to just file for bankruptcy like a lot of the trucking, car dealers? You're going to lay off of people, thousands of people like Wells Fargo did? Or are you going to be like, I can't think of things. I know the car dealers laid off, banks laid off. Or are you going to let your house go off the foreclosure? You're already commuting 2 to 3 hours to work to pay for your loan, because pay for your house loan, because there's no businesses close to your house that can cover you, and you're trying to go to some job 3 to 4 hours away. What happens if that company leaves California? What happens if that company just lays you off, period, because they outsource? So in order for you to get ready to deal with the pain of 2020 is you need me to give you a quick recap of GrowthCon 4. $5,995. That's the value you're going to get. If you had tried to do this on your own, we're talking about spending $50,000 for the speaker. You got to pay for your trip to Vegas. You got to find a hotel room. You got to get to the event. You got to spend 3 days there. And you got to take out the notes. Then once you take the notes back, you're going to come back and apply them. So, and then I want to thank some of you guys who are helping make my no views into 1 or 2 views. We're slowly getting up there. I want you to share this, comment, let me know. Do you think we're going to have pain in 2020? Do you think when a lot of these businesses see Trump is going to like have his powers limited, they're not going to lay off people? Do you really think they're going to let the Democrat keep taxing them? Do you think they're going to let the Democrats take away their tax deduction without equalizing it somehow? Let me know, comment, subscribe. I need to get up to 120 subscribers so we can go live. Let's do it!